the objective of this module is to portray the emotions and, well, as you know, it's just to portray the emotions of the character Mario from Mario and Luigi Super Smash Bros.
At the moment we're into week 5 and we've been doing planning from obviously week 1, and we've managed to get the storyboarding and a motion list and the optimized motion list, which was actually quite difficult because I was pretty thorough on the first motion list, so apart from that it's just been fine line and going over the storyboard. At the moment I got Yorkie to put together a storyboard out of screenshots. I did a hand-drawn one which will be eventually put on the computer as a scanner and then handed over to Yorkie to colour in.
The software that I'll be using will be firstly the Vicon motion capture suite or studio, and that'll be generating the 3D coordinates, and that will build it into a file. From that we'll be using Autodesk Motion Builder, and that will read all the 3D data and then show it as like an output that we can see, understand. We will also be using 3ds Max maybe to bring in some assets, maybe like a tree in like the Mario scene, the tube that it'll come out of, maybe like one of the piranha flowers as well. We will also be using Photoshop possibly to generate some textures, some 2D textures.
Scott, doing work. Oh, he's so awesome. The camera caught up a cheek looking at him.
Look at his lovely hat.
Look at that, man.
The hat is lovely. Looks like you're wearing a
And then there's me, and I'm doing nothing because I don't do anything.
I believe that our motion capture take went very well. It ran very smoothly, and the suit that Yorkie was wearing with all the motion capture balls, it fitted perfectly. It never slipped, and we never had any occlusion going through the cameras, and everything showed up very nice in Vicon screen. One area we did have a slight problem was the shot of Yorkie jumping high in the air. Whenever he gets to a certain height, the balls do disappear from the view of the cameras, which might cause a problem in Motion Builder. We have taken two different motion recordings and hoping to blend them together in Motion Builder. However, we won't be able to know, or we can't tell, until we do import it to Motion Builder.
Okay, here we got Motion Builder open. We've managed to get all the data imported into Motion Builder. Just swinging around the viewport, making sure that we can see all the little dots or crosses, which basically represents each of the different balls that was on the motion capture suit. Obviously, just saw there the playing through one of the takes. Okay, we've managed to get the actor set up, and we've also put the Surfer Dude character alongside him. They are joined together, so as you can see, as the actor moves, the Surfer Dude moves perfectly in time, follows the exact actions, which is the method that we're using to create our animation.
Managed to get the Surfer Dude mesh on top of the actor, and we put them all in sequence, put all the animations together, and now we're just trying to keyframe them so
he basically stays in one place or is in the correct position the entire time.
We want him to come up the tube instead of just starting on top.
Yeah.
But we don't know how to do it. But we might have the solution. Does that have to be fun?
No!
Okay.
No!
Frustration for Scott.
Okay, fix the problem. We have to be in editing mode instead of story mode.
Basically, it allows us to reposition the character, basically putting keyframes so it stays in position and then swiftly transitions to you.
Okay, he's in the barrel, so 0, let's make a keyframe. I don't know how to make a keyframe. Oh, yeah!
Hello, we're near the end of our editing now. We're currently just keyframing everything, making sure it's all in the right position. And Scott's working with the wonderful motion builder.
Yeah, we've finally been able to figure out how to actually move our character. It was using like this pivot point, and now, la-di-da, we can move our character so that he can shoot up and then he can jump out.
It's-a me, Mario!
Hello! Okay, so we've finally got our animation done. It's all there, nice, lovely, running smoothly. Overall, I think the project went pretty well. We managed to get most of the stuff done quite early. We had a little bit of a problem with keyframing and initially trying to get all the animations together, but eventually we managed to work it out and finish it. Improvements, I would have said, probably at the end we were originally planning on having the having Mario doing the peace sign. However, we couldn't find a way to edit the fingers, so I reckon if we were to do the project again, that would be my main improvement for the project. Yeah, that's it.
It fell off!